The middle-aged candy store, the middle-aged candy store. Have a good time, try lemon and lime at the middle-aged candy store. The candy is sweet, it's true, though it may seem bitter to you. Wave back at the years, the trials and the tears, the cigarettes and beers, the faces you love, the things you're sorry for. Come in for a spell, there's caramel at the middle-aged candy store.
Hey there, and welcome to the store. I'm Karen, and I'm the manager. So, there's a lot to see here as we look over the shelves. Why don't you give it a look-see? Some bright wrappers with bold colors, and packages and boxes with that fun lettering to get you to buy. Maybe a surprise or two. Maybe something nasty. So, what do you choose? What do you look for when you want a break? Some escape? Some sweet memory from years ago to chew on? There's a lot of selection here anyway. I even have my own homemade concoction of sweets that I sell. Try this one.
Isabel was obsessed with her beautiful red hair. She invested much time and money into medications and conditioners that promised to protect it. Isabel commanded her servants to collect every strand of her hair they found and return them to her. These she stuffed into a pillow, which she slept upon to guard herself from baldness. But all her spells and potions failed. One night there was a terrible fire, and Isabel escaped with her pillow and her life, but not her lovely red hair, which perished in the flames. Moral? A smoking pillow is a poor companion to a bald woman.
What's wrong? Did that candy taste a little strange to you? Well, you know that will happen sometimes, especially in a store like this. I mean, you didn't think that this store was just run-of-the-mill, did you? Just another candy store, dishing out bland vanilla pastis? Gosh, I sure hope not. Here's a secret, my dear patron. I was only getting your strange buds ready for the main confection. Have a taste of this doozy. It's called Pirate Gnome Jeopardy.
This is Jeopardy. The first of the categories today: acorn rides, raccoon tail parts, types of assholes, famous marsupial architecture, great monkey thinkers. A severed head in the hand is worth two in the toy box.
Famous marsupial architecture for 100 grams of PCP.
All right, here I am. In the day before this age, in a telepathic message on the Overlord balloon head, this marsupial dreamed up a way to turn sausages into erasers. Gnomer.
Who is the baby Jesus?
Right!
Famous marsupial architecture for 400 grams of PCP.
Let's go back there. Make me a la 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 la. And don't you think I'm a dot?
My pata 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 so wee down down.
Honk! Honk! No.
I'm falling down the want toys now.
You want to stay with it? Here's the clue. No one knows how it got there, but there is a giant Palomino horse in the lower left-hand corner of this important national hair drain, just beneath the concluding words, "My sincere yellow liver." Now to Mr. Nomi.
What is the time of time, not tomorrow, but Orange Julius special? Hey, I didn't order this.
Correct, Mr. Nomi. 400 grams of PCP goes to you. Now it is time to pull out our spines and travel deep into the bellies of the clouds.
I'll fight you. Let's go. Oh, shit. We're taking off. Oh, never mind. Okay, I get it. We're going to finish this round on the other planet. Okay. Let's do it. Adiance! Okay. Acorn Rides!
Sing with me. Let's come back now,
peaceful thoughts.
Taking an acorn ride down. Take an acorn.
Contestants, let's go to a commercial break. And now I'll need your help dragging this monkey.
Thank you for listening to the Middle-Aged Candy Store, produced by The Gathering. Podcasts appear every first and third Tuesdays of the month. Karen was performed by Karen Loomer. Pirate Gnome Jeopardy was written by Linda Febbleston and performed by Kristen Mueller-Heeslip and Donnie and Linda Febbleston.
Isabel, written by Karen Loomer, performed by Linda Febbleston.
Theme music by Donnie Febbleston, performed by Donnie and Linda Febbleston.
Come in for a spell.